tell us in the comments. Don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with everyone you know.
Actually, ano siya eh, it's it doesn't start from the dream eh. It's more like an accident. When my father is playing table tennis here in my in our neighborhood, I was accidentally I was looking for him actually at the street. So I saw him playing at the streets, and that's the time that I tried to play. Of course, my father don't want me to send me home alone. So he allowed me to go there, and he teach me how to play. Actually, he just let me play the table tennis, and I love it myself. So,
yes.
Well, of course, syempre, mga bata tayo. So if we are engaged on something na we are kind of fascinated, of course, yung fascination ko is towards table tennis eh. Yung iba is basketball, yung iba is other sports at the street. So just so happened I was introduced in table tennis, and I was fascinated by it. So dun ko ginugol yung time ko. So yun yung reason why table tennis. I first represent the Philippines here in Manila. We had a Southeast Asian Junior table tennis competition.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, that was in Harrison. One thing's for sure, I never made a promise to my coaches or to the sports office na mag-5-peat or something like that. Ang sinabi ko sa kanila, especially to my teammates, of course, ayoko silang i-disappoint that time. When I was a rookie, I can feel the pressure eh. Ako yung rookie, pero ako yung ano eh, ako yung tinitignan nila, which is sobrang hirap niya. Sobrang hirap niya kasi maraming senior sa amin eh sa nung time na yun sa team. Ang hirap nung inaasahan ka nila to step up. So talagang parang it's a lot to take. Na ang sinabi ko talaga is mag-work hard ako para manalo tayo dito.
Yeah.
Kumbaga, game by game natin siya gagawin, point by point. So yun lang, sabi ko talaga i-dedicate ko yung 5 years career ko.
Yeah.
Collegiate career ko sa Benil. Yun lang
and
sinabi ko sa
it paid off. It's incredibly paid off. I mean, you brought five championships in 5 years. And 5 MVPs in 5 years.
Marami na rin akong mga tournaments sa Sinalian, such as SEA Games, Asian Games, and World Championships, of course. Let's start from World Championships. I played World Championships in Malaysia. By division kasi siya eh. So, yung Philippines, yung Division 1 is nandun talaga yung mga powerhouse, which is China, Japan.
Yeah.
Division 3.
Yeah.
Nasa Division 3 kami nun. So, napataas namin yung, hindi kami nakapag-get ng medal kasi hindi kami dun sa Division 1. So, napataas namin yung rankings ng Philippines noon from 78, if I'm not mistaken, we went up to 63.
World nice.
The values siguro yung una is persistent. Of course, if you have dreams and if you're really looking forward to make a difference to your life, talagang yung persistence kasi andun talaga yung ups and downs. Doubters, bashers, andyan siya eh. If merong mga nag-a-admire sa'yo, andyan sila. So you just have to be persistent enough to pursue it. And of course, yung faith to God, of course, yun yung pinaka-importante. Actually, yun yung pinaka-importante kasi yun yung mag-boost sa lahat eh. I mean, if everything is falling apart, dun ka talaga kakapit. And of course yung leadership is important kasi yun nga yung skill kasi natuturo, yung knowledge natuturo, pero yung pagiging leader or setting an example to others, yun talaga yung something na it takes time and talaga yeah. yun yung pinatrabaho talaga ng mahabang panahon.
Yes.
Most enjoyable part, of course, siguro masasabi ko yung ano, yung preparation towards the competition itself.
That's interesting.
Yes, preparation. Yeah. Of course, kasi doon mo makikita talaga yung every attitude ng teammates mo, ng every athlete. Kasi ang ano naman namin sa school is discipline talaga. If may, kumbaga, ako kasi nag-dorm ako. So, of course, may mga dorm mates.
Yeah.
May mga umuwi sa kanya-kanyang houses nila. So, hindi kami nangingilam dun sa kung ano man yung gusto nilang gawin. I mean, if kung gusto nilang mag-stay up late outside, it's up to them. If magpupuyat sila, it's up to them. So,
yeah.
Pag preparation kasi sa tournament, dun mo makikita yung discipline ng bawat isa. Eh. So, yun yung pinaka-highlights talaga dun kasi dun ko nakikita na parang hindi lang ako yung may gusto eh. Hindi lang ako yung nag-i-influence ito sa team. I mean, pag nakikita ko silang ganun, nabuboost din ako eh na mag-training or mag-perform pa even more.
Mm.
So, yung iba, sasabihin nila siguro after yung pag nanalo na sa championship, pero sa akin kasi is for me is yung preparation talaga papunta dun sa tournament kasi
yes.
Dun mo sila makikilala eh. I mean, syempre lahat na tao pwedeng maging masaya, pero yung
yeah.
during time na nahihirapan ka to showcase your discipline, to showcase your passion to something, or to showcase your goal, pagiging goal oriented mo, yun yung highlights for me on this case. Yes. Of course, sa mentality, it's more on the mind. So you just have to shift. You just have to pick up your mindset from there and use that to your current career. Like as of the moment, I'm currently working at Citibank right now.
Yeah.
So dun ko siya nilalagay. Dun, kumbaga kung lagi ko nilalabas yung A game ko sa table tennis.
Yeah.
Nilalagay ko yung nilalagay ko ngayon. Kumbaga hindi ko pa siya fully nalalagay, pero dun ko hinuhugot yung A game ko dito sa work. Of course, it's hard for us to start from the beginning eh. Of course, with the guidance of my manager, Luis Tanay in Citibank, he's guiding me to adjust. Nag-open ako sa kanya and sobrang galing niya manager. Nakakapag-open ako sa kanya ng mga previous situation ko, kung ano nafe-feel ko ngayon, kung paano ako nasa transition from being one of the best.
Yeah.
To a
the best, to a not one of the best, the best.
One of the best. from a starter on that field. Of course, especially that is banking. Hindi ako magaling sa math. Ayoko talaga sa math. Ayoko ng accounting, hirap ako diyan. Hirap ako sa kung ano man yung
may madaming accounting sa Benilda, grabe. Tatlong accounting.
Madami, lahat ng mahirap na subject na sa binil na. So, yung transition ko na share ko sa kanya and he's guiding me towards the transition. And yun, ganun ko siya iniisip is talagang kung ano yung mindset ko dito, lalagay ko siya dito. And maybe, baka mag-work siya towards the end of the stick or towards latter part of the career in corporate world. Baka dalhin din ako somewhere. I'm very hopeful to that one. So, ganun ako nag-cope up dun sa longingness sa action.
Yeah.
Siguro yun more like na I don't settle for okay. Parang ganun. Mm.
Kasi, yeah. Perfect for your career.
Sa training, every day, if you want to improve, you have to put in on your mindset or on yourself na every day you are improving it. So in that way, mag-i-improve ka talaga. Hindi mo haantayin, you don't have to wait for the outcome. Na nagte-training ka and then you'll get to say na gumaling ka if you want. yeah. For me, it's not like that. You have to feel it that you're improving every day. Likewise, yeah. Here in my current career, of course, bank, you're dealing with someone else's money, someone else's information, sensitive yeah. information. You're dealing with that. And during this pandemic, we're working at home. You have to have the integrity. You have to put yourself na kailangan mong mag-step up. Kasi kung ano man yung magkamali dyan, you will held accountable. So, yes. Talagang kailangan mong dalin yung mindset mo na every day you have to put yourself on a AAA standards, parang ganun. Of course, yeah. I'm just freeing up my time or medyo nag-adjust pa sa time kasi gabi nga. So naghahanap pa ako ng tamang time to yeah. play. And someone yeah. to play with, of course, kasi baliktad nga yeah. yung schedule. Of course, especially dun sa mga student athlete na independent, yung yeah. nilang itaguyod yung sarili nila, like myself. I'm proudly to say na I'm supporting myself since high school. Meron yeah. ako mga allowances to support my financially, and that is something that my parents taught me na I have to do it myself. And yung ang advice ko dun sa mga student athlete na thinking to pursue their career is, of course, hindi naman mawawala is if yung masusuportan ka ba ng sport financially. Kasi yun yung pinaka-importante din eh. Kung masusuportan ka financially or financially capable naman ikaw, and you have, if you want to, and you want to pursue your sport, that will be great. Because yun nga, hindi naman overnight yung sports natin. Hindi tayo naging athlete overnight. Nag-training tayo for so long to reach yeah. this position. So nasa sa inyo pa rin yung decision if you will pursue. You just have to kailangan nyo siyang i-wait. If masusuporta naman kayo financially and gusto nyo pursue yung career na yon, go for it. But if you're going to think wisely, if that sport will not, you know, somehow short yung financial capability nung makukuha mo through that sport, siguro ano pa rin, mag-work pa rin kayo. If kaya mag-sport, why not? Pero yun nga, it's up to them to decide for that. So yun lang yung take ko dun sa ano na yun. Yeah. To the people to discover table tennis eh, kasi maraming benefit ang playing table tennis. Of course, hindi siya contact sport, hindi ka masasaktan yeah. dito. And talaga gumagana lahat, katawan mo yeah. yung utak mo and all. So talagang it's up for the people to discover the sport and love the sport talaga. And that way, if maging ano siya, maging mag-hit siya sa lahat, I feel magiging ano siya, magkakaroon siya ng pro scene, magkakaroon ng teams, nice. Magbabayad na mag-in-house ng athletes, which is, yun nga, in that way, masusuportahan yung financially, yung mga athletes. It's yeah. a lifetime achievement kasi for me. Starting your NCAA journey and ending up with yun nga, sabi lang, with a bang. So, ayun talaga, yeah. most memorable experience ko during collegiate and table tennis career.
Yes.
Yun talaga. I was yes. the last player to play for the team for the yeah. win. The team is leading 2-1. We're up 2-1 on the team and ako yung last player na maglalaro to clinch the final win for the team to achieve the 5-peat champion. So nung mga previous just to share lang real quick, yung mga previous championships, hindi ako masyadong naging emotional. I celebrated pero hindi ako ganun naging ka-emotional towards it. Parang kasi first year we've won, parang excitement, adrenaline. Second year, third year and fourth year, more like we are in this game. We got this. I mean, championship still on. Pero nung fifth year, nung nanalo ko, I just went down. I held the ground and I was crying. I mean, parang yung mga previous years ng NCAA ko, nag-sink in na lang siya bigla lahat towards that very moment. I mean, di talaga ako makapaniwala. Naiwan ko yung camera ko recording for how many minutes dun sa table. Yung racket ko, naiwan ko na dun. Hindi ko na siya naalala. I mean, talagang sobrang, ano talaga ako, sobrang shock ako sa mga nangyari. So, yun yung na-feel ko. Sobrang surreal talaga. Of course, most importantly, never forgot to finish your studies. Most important thing kasi it's not only your achievement eh, it's your parents' achievement as well. I mean, talagang kaya kanila tinuruan to play table tennis para to be good and of course to finish college, especially my scholarship. So never skip schooling as much as possible and train hard. Naniniwala ako sa mga athletes here in the Philippines, especially in table tennis, na kaya natin mag-contest sa all competitions outside the Philippines. Kaya natin. Nakita ko siya. It's just that we just need the right push, the right support, and who knows? Baka magkaroon tayo ng Olympic champion someday.
Not all athletes have the opportunity to pursue sports when their time is up. Like Ryan, when he ended his collegiate journey. Even generation talent like Ryan wasn't spared from this. But if there's one thing Ryan's story taught us, it's that sports has the power to turn one's dreams into reality. Just like how Ryan was one day. He was a kid hoping to play table tennis. And he eventually achieved 5 MVPs and 5 championships. And solidified his name as one of the greatest NCAA athletes of all time. That's what sports does best. It makes people do amazing things.
Stay tuned for the next episode.
Only here on V81 Radio, Manila.